Today I'm going to show you how to make a little jellyfish. So here's the jellyfish. So you need scissors, yarn needle, and you can use a 4 millimeter hook or a 3.75. I'm using a 3.75. You're going to make a slip knot. I'm going to start out with the simple circle, which I also have a video for. Go chain two. Go in through your first loop. Pull one. Pull through both loops. And one more. You're going to go in through the middle of your stitch. And you're going to make 10 single stitches. And 10. All right. So here you got your circle. Now you're going to double every stitch all the way around. That's your second row. Right, so for the next three rows, it's just single stitch all the way around, no increasing, no decreasing. And it's going to start to cup in, so we're going to flip it outwards. All right, so that gives us 5 rows total. So we count from the center, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Well, it should look like this, like a little bowl. And then for the last row, we're gonna do the seashell stitch. So double crochet, 3.
I got your left flower, but it's dry.
Thank you, honey. Okay, so double crochet 3 into one hole. Right? Should look like that. And then the next stitch is a single stitch. Right? So it makes this pretty little seashell pattern. So the next stitch, double crochet 3 into the same hole. And then single stitch, and you're going to do that all the way around. And now my dog's barking. All the way around. So it should look like this, kind of like a hat. It's a pretty little hat. So the last stitch is a slip stitch. You're gonna go in, pull straight through both loops, and then one more. And we're just gonna cut it. So for the next step, to do the tentacles, so we're going to flip this the other way. We're going to attach our tentacles to the inside. So you're going to go straight through under here. Well, sorry, the middle. Like this. And I like to do them in 2 different colors. You can do them all the same color, whichever you want. Okay. So we're going to pull straight through. And we're going to pull your short end through the loop. Pull all the way through. Pull it tight. And we're going to tie a knot. Like that. Then you're going to go back through that same hole. Pull through once. And then you're gonna chain 20 loops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Right? Now we have our chain. So you're gonna skip this first loop right here. And you're going to double crochet 2 to each hole all the way down. that'll give it that nice twisted effect. And make sure you're putting two in each hole or it's going to end up straight instead of curly. And if you want it to curl even tighter, you can add three to each hole, or three, then two, then three. Because putting three in every one kind of makes it overcrowded, and then it's difficult. Alright, so we've reached the end, and you can see we've got this nice little curly tentacle. Right. So for the last part, we're going to join, go in through that same spot, slip stitch, and then add one more. Okay, so that gives us our first tentacle, and we're going to do two more. So we're kind of third it, and it doesn't really make too much of a difference where you pick. Straight through, slip stitch, and one more, and chain up 20. 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Eight. And same thing, you're gonna double crochet two in every loop. back down to the end, go same spot, slip straight through, and one more. Now we're going to do the last tentacle. Slips through, and one more. Chain up 20. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Right? And then again, double crochet, 2 to each hole. I missed one. That's okay. My advice to people is, if you miss one increase, don't worry about it. Just move along. It's like you're not going to notice. No one else is going to notice at the end. Simply because that's a lot of stitches. And kind of cut, slip stitch, pull it through. Now you have 3 tentacles. And we're going to sew these ends in to get them out of the way. Last one. So this last end in. Ah! And now for the easy last part, we're gonna add this little fringe just around the edge. So I'm going to do both colors like I did that one. You can kind of just look how long your jellyfish is. And I kind of wanted about that long, so you just double that length. And then all you gotta do to know how many strings to cut is count all your little petals. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You're just going to take your string, fold it in half, take your hook, and you're going to go through the middle of your seashell stitch right there. Pull it through, and then pull all the way through, pull it tight. And that's how you do your fringe. I'm just going to alternate the colors all the way around. And I did these lighter colors because it is so dark and cloudy today because it is raining outside. So the lighting is a little dim, even though I have all these lights on in my room. It's not helping. All right. last one. Now we have this cute little jellyfish. Thanks for watching.